Last week, Melania Trump revealed that she is staunchly pro-choice, despite her husband perhaps doing more to restrict access to reproductive rights than anyone else in American history, and likely to do even more if he becomes president again. So, with that as sort of the background, here is her updated commentary about the topic.
Had you spoken to President Trump about that before you wrote that in the book?
Yes, he knew my position and my beliefs since the day we met. I believe in individual freedom. I want to decide what I want to do with my body.
Okay, so that is consistent with what she has said in her creepy videos and what she wrote in her book. And while I disagree with virtually everything else she's ever done or said or been in her life, I do like her position on these issues. I do, though, have a bit of a question, yes, about how, like, okay, he let you do it. First of all, please don't frame it that way, because how the hell would he stop you? It's you writing the book. It's not up to him what you get to say. But that said, I do want to talk in a moment about the gap between them on this issue. We're going to give you just a little bit more of Melania first.
I don't want government in my personal business. I think it's very important. And I, as I said in the book, and it's very well explained in the chapter, what does really my body, my choice means? Because timing really matters, and also the restrictions.
It was interesting that you wrote this in the book right before a presidential election.
Well, that was not written in the last week or the last month.
That these are your convictions.
Correct, but that book was written months before.
Small note, but that book was written, not I wrote that book. Could be a language thing. It's probably not. But anyway, so look, she's saying I did not put this out just to help or hurt the Republicans in the election. I wrote it a long time ago, which I generally believe. These books do tend to get written earlier, even if possibly by ghostwriters. So I sort of buy that. But I do have a question, though, because like she's talking about how, like, let me give you one more quote. Bartiromo says, how do you think the Republicans and President Trump have handled this issue? To which she says, he knew my beliefs, as I said, so he knew it would be in the book. He let me be who I am, and he let me believe what I believe. Again, you don't need to put let, but okay. He let me be my own person, and he respects that. And I respect that as I let him be his own person. He has different beliefs, and he will do what he believes. And at this point, I'd just like to insert my own opinion. What the hell are you talking about? He'll have his own beliefs. He's not some random dude with an abstract philosophy that's disconnected. He made it happen. The end of those rights for tens of millions of people. Women have died because of what he did. Yeah. This isn't like he likes baseball, I like football. We're each our own individual people. That's not what happened at all. He believes it, so he put the judges on. They took away the rights. That's not a small difference between partners. He respects my opinion. No, he doesn't. He thinks you're dead wrong. You think it's up to you. He doesn't think that. He doesn't think you should. Well, maybe if you happen to be lucky enough to be in one of the civilized states. But if you live in a place that's just a little too red, no, all that stuff about individual liberty and having control of your body, he does not actually believe that. And I know most people don't care. What does it matter if they disagree about this? But like, you can have disagreements. This is the most substantive disagreement I think that I've ever seen between a partnership, Francesca.
Well, John, her voice is so, I forgot how sweet and high. I think it's gone up a few registers. And so Slovenian.
I feel like my impressions of her have been a little too Christmas.
Who gives a crap about Christmas? But now she's different because she has to sell a book.
This is all a ploy to sell the book, you guys. This is all this a ploy to sell the massive, mostly pictures Melania book that you're gonna like have in on your coffee table. What? Like, I love that also she sold a coffee table book, which we all know is just a reason to sell a more expensive book. So it's probably like, you know, $60 instead of, you know, $13. But anyway, I think this is all BS. I think I'm sure you talked about it, but I've talked about it. I think this is a complete ploy because Bartiromo asks her, well, what do you think of what Trump has done and Republicans? And then she gives this non-answer. Bartiromo, she won't because she works for Fox News. But if she actually pressed it, but like said it, asked her exactly what you said. Overturning Roe v. Wade via the Dobbs decision, thanks to the Supreme Court justices that your husband put in, have effectively triggered abortion bans and stripped away that individual right for millions of women. If you right now, Melania, were living in Alabama or Georgia, things would be very, or Texas, things would be very, very different for you. What say you?
Well, you know, he is his own person.
Like what? So I just, you know, there was news last week that CNN refused to pay Melania $250,000 for an interview. I think that they messed up. I think they should pay her that money because she's just grifting and asking news outlets for money. Pay her the money so you can actually ask her the question. Otherwise, John, doesn't this feel to me like a little bit of a J.D. Vance pivot of a like, we need to do better. You know, we need to make sure women trust us. And you know what? It is our body, our choice. This is co-optation. This is gaslighting. Yeah, I don't believe this for a second.
No, I don't either. I'm gonna end with this one quote. This is from a book. She said, why should anyone other than the woman herself have the power to determine what she does with her own body? Melania Trump, I am begging you. Don't ask us that. Ask your husband that. Because he seems to think someone else should. Thanks for watching our video. Did you know that you can support our show by becoming a subscriber? Just click the subscribe button and also ring the bell so that you get notifications when we're live or when we post new content.